everyone, it's Hannah, and today I'm going to show you the basic technique that is used in making all of these bits that you can see on your screen. So all these different things that I've made are all using the same stitch, which is the one I'm demonstrating today. So it's just to show you how versatile brick stitch actually is. So although I'm not actually going to show you how to do any of these patterns today, I'll be teaching you the basic techniques of brick stitch, and so in future when I do tutorials on these bits, then I can just refer you back to this video. So the beads that I'll be using for today's tutorial are size 11 Delica beads. They are much better suited to brick stitch, as you can see. They sit together flush, which is what you need. I attempted to make this video using size 8 seed beads, and it didn't work, so we're going for size 11 Delicas. I have pre-threaded my needle, which is a size 10 beading needle, with some black Nymo, just as a contrasting colour. Obviously, if you were to do this properly, please use a colour that matches, or is at least vaguely similar, so it isn't obvious. So, to start brick stitch, you need to do a foundation row of ladder stitch. So I'm just going to pick up two of the beads and slide them, slide them down my thread. I've slid them down my thread, left a bit of a tail so you can sew it in afterwards. And now I'm going up through that first bead we threaded on. So here's our tail, going through that first bead and pull. And so ladder stitch is all about making circles. So although you can see they are sat nice and next to each other, we need to complete the circle. So now we're going down through this next bead. Like so. And then you pick up another bead, just one this time. And because we came out of the bottom of this bead, we want to carry on the circle. So going back round and going through the top of that bead. And because we've come down through this bead, we want to finish the circle, so we're going back up through this bead. And then you just pick up another bead. And because we're coming out the top of this one, we want to continue the circle round, so we're going up through the underside of this one. And because we are now coming out the top of this, we want to continue the circle round. So going back down through this one. Like so. See how it's forming? So you just keep continuing to do that until the base length has the right number of beads for your pattern. And it varies with every pattern, so I can't tell you a set thing. So that's your first row of ladder stitch done. It's a bit higgledy-piggledy and a bit all over the place. That's fine. Some people like to go back through it so it straightens up. I find that it straightens up on the next round anyway. So it is personal preference. And if it doesn't straighten up on the next round, then I'd go through it at the end. So the next round, we are actually starting our brick stitch. Our first proper row. So much like with ladder stitch, we are picking up two beads. Now, what we're going to do to form the brick stitch is to go underneath that thread bridge. So underneath that thread bridge, careful not to pierce the thread bridge. So going underneath that bit there, you see? Good. And pull that through. And you see the beads want to sit next to each other, yay! So to finish off this stitch, all you need to do now is to go up through that second bead that we threaded on. And there we go. Next stitch, we are only picking up one bead. So picking up one bead, going underneath the next thread bridge. Like so. much like before, going now up through that bead, like so. So I've picked up a bead, going through the next thread bridge, and back up through that bead. See, I told you it straightens up on the next round. So picking up another bead underneath the next thread bridge. And then up through the next bead. And that's your first row of brick stitch done. So now I'm going to teach you how to decrease, which is what you need to learn to do all the patterns I showed you at the beginning. So, like with the normal brick stitch, I'm picking up two beads, but instead of going through that first bridge we've got, I'm gonna skip that one, I'm gonna go through the second, we're going to go up through that first bead like we did before. But you'll notice that they don't quite want to sit flat because they're annoying. So then what you want to do to flatten them up is to go through that first one again in a downwards motion. Then back up through that second one. I don't know if this is technically the right way to do it, I taught myself, so if it's not, I'm sorry. And you'll see that we've skipped that first step, so we've decreased it. And then you just continue along the row as you did before, picking up a bead, going underneath the next thread bridge. And there we go. You have decreased a row. If you have a count, the purple row has 7 beads. This one only has 6. So now I'm going to show you how to increase a row, which is also almost needed in all of the patterns, except for the bunting necklace. So I shall show you that one. So pick up 2 seed beads. Go through that first thread bridge. You're not skipping one this time, that's only decreasing. And then up through that second bead. And then pick up another bead and continue the row as per usual. Okay, so this may be a little bit difficult to show, but I've only got 1 bead left to put on this row, but I want to increase, so I technically have 2 beads, otherwise I won't have increased by any. So I'm going to do that last stitch as I normally would. And then to increase, you pick up yet another bead, you're under the same thread bridge. So they share a bridge. So it goes under the same thread bridge. And pull. So now they sit next to each other and you see we've increased again. So both purple rows have 7 and the middle pink row has 6. And that's basically all you need to know with brick stitch, except for how to finish it off, and I shall show you how to do that. So to finish it off, all you do is you sew back through the beads. You don't have tiny knots or anything, just make sure you sew back through enough of the beads. So make sure the beads line up. You don't want to be able to see the thread, ideally. See. can go up through that one there. And down through that one there. And yeah, just keep back sewing back through your work, then cut it off with a pair of nice sharp scissors. Like so. And you just snip that bit of the thread off, then you have to sew back with this one as well. And ta-da! That's how you do brick stitch. So I hope that you liked this video. If you did, please feel free to give it a good old thumbs up. Your support means an awful lot to me. As well, you may as well hit subscribe. I post two videos a week, one on a Thursday and one on a Sunday. I'd love to have you stick around in the corner of craft. If you decide to use any of my tutorials to make anything of your very own, please feel free to put a picture of it on Instagram with the hashtag #thecornerofcraft so I can check it out. And I shall see you on Sunday for my next video. Bye!